The Book of the Sacred Magic of Abramelin, or sometimes just called the Book of Abramelin, is a book outlining one of the most mystical and rigorous rituals said to exist. The purpose of the ritual is to theoretically evoke the 12 kings and dukes of hell and bind them, the purpose being to allow the individual magician to visit and learn magical secrets from one's holy guardian angel. The entire ritual is said to take about 18 months to fully complete, filled with daily fasting, meditation, and limiting one's social interaction in order to put the magician in such a state that they will no longer fear the goetic demons evoked. The book was said to have been translated by one of the founders of the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn, Samuel Liddell McGregor Mathers, the famously known occult group that Aleister Crowley was commonly associated with. It is said Aleister Crowley himself attempted this ritual but miserably failed, leaving mid-ritual and cursing the home he performed it in, the famous Bullaskine House. Not many people have attempted the full ritual. Some have attempted different revisions of it that take less time than the original ritual itself. The ritual, also known as the Abramelin Operation, was depicted in the movie A Dark Song. Some occultists say many scenes were fabricated to better fit cinematics, but essentially the purpose of the ritual is still heavily depicted in a decent manner in the movie. As I explained before, the ritual requires an immersed and sharpened state of mind. Like many occult rituals, it requires many different aspects in order for completion. Occultists say the magician performing needs to be keen in many fields such as psychology, philosophy, geometry, and language. Though this isn't necessarily required, it definitely helps completing the ritual, specifically geometry. Within the Book of Abramelin, there are tables that are linked to goetic spirits that the magician needs to decrypt in order to see the link between the demon and the magician, allowing the magician to evoke and bind the demon. This ritual has many similarities to the Lesser Keys of Solomon, said to be what King Solomon did and as a result was able to attain wealth, power, and build his temple by summoning and binding the goetic spirits to copper sigils. Not much is known what happens after the completion of the ritual. Anecdotal reports say people have attained great wealth, power, as well as being able to physically visit their holy guardian angel. There are many subjective experience reports you can find on many blogs, videos, and on Reddit. Though whether these experiences are genuine or fabricated, that is for you to decide.